Welcome, everybody. Welcome, welcome, welcome to The Tonight Show. You're here. You made it. Thank you for watching. Well, guys, today in Washington, President Biden had his annual physical exam. Or as my writers call it, Christmas. That's right. That's right. This morning, Biden went to Walter Reed Medical Center for his yearly physical. The good news is Biden is doing great. However, the doctor who examined him hasn't blinked in 7 hours. Yeah, the exam was important, although bringing Biden in for a physical is kind of like bringing your iPhone 3 to the Genius Bar. It's like, I guess we can look at it. There's not much we can do with this thing. But things got off to a bit of a rough start when Biden took off his pants and the nurse said, "Sir, this is the waiting room. I mean, wait till you get inside." Once Biden made it in, the doctor was like, "Who gave him anesthesia?" The nurse said, "No, that's just how he is." But the president is actually in fantastic shape. Apparently, he wanders 10,000 steps a day, which is nice to hear. 10,000 a day. Isn't that amazing? It wasn't all great news for Biden. Unfortunately, they gave him a colonoscopy and found several more classified documents. And, you know, that's unfortunate. That's right, Biden had his physical, and while I'm sure his doctors were very thorough, I wanted to ask some follow-up questions myself. So if you don't mind, we're gonna talk to him right now. Mr. President, thank you for doing this. To begin, can you please turn and cough? All right, thank you very much. Let's do a quick vision test, okay? Can you read these letters top to bottom?
I can't quite see what I can't.
You know what? Forget it. It's fine. Don't worry about that. Real quick, what is your typical resting heart rate?
2.
Okay. That's pretty low. Moving on, what did the doctor say when he finished your colonoscopy?
That tunnel is 150 years old.
All right, well, that's interesting. I don't know if that's... Well, now, how many hours of sleep are you getting a night?
8 hours.
Okay, that's good. And how many hours of sleep are you getting during the day?
8 hours.
Okay, now, what have you been wearing to bed to avoid those frequent trips to the bathroom?
Depends.
Now, sometimes a doctor will say someone's as strong as an ox. What did yours compare you to?
A 5'2" little Irish lady.
Okay, that's... Finally, Mr. President, we're gonna do a stress test, okay? Can you start running some stairs? All right. You know what? Hey, never mind. Thank you very much. Sorry to bother you, sir. Thank you. Well, some more big news from Washington. Today, Mitch McConnell announced he's stepping down as the Senate Republican leader this November. When the news broke, my writers were like, "Oh, my God, it's double Christmas." Yep, after nearly 2 decades as the Republican leader of the Senate, McConnell is stepping down. McConnell just turned 82, so that can only mean one thing. He's running for president. And that's right. McConnell actually joined the Senate in 1985. Whoa. Can we see him back then? Oh, he looked cool. McConnell said that it's time for the next generation of leadership. Then he looked around the Senate and realized the next generation is 75. He's like, Well, guys, we're a few days away from a potential government shutdown. It's unclear if Congress can pass a spending bill on time, and now several members of Congress are speaking up about it. For example, Senator Rand Paul said, "We need to get this done already. The constant fighting is getting old, man." And Congressman Jack Bergman said, "Did someone say old man? Sorry, I thought you were talking about me. Anyway, we need people on both sides of the aisle to lend an ear." And Senator Ted Budd said, "Did someone say lend an ear? Sorry, I thought you were talking about me. Anyway, our approval rating is low and we need to get it up." And Congresswoman Frederica Wilson said, "Did someone say giddy up?" Anyway, this whole thing makes me feel like I'm about to cry. And Congressman Max Miller said, "Did someone say about to cry?" Anyway, I think all of us are feeling stretched thin. And Congressman David Kustoff said, "Did someone say stretched thin?" Anyway, we're already dealing with so much. Let's not throw more chaos on top. And Congressman Sri Tanadar said, did someone say chaos on top? Anyway, the threats from Republicans are totally toothless. And Congressman Bob Latta said, did someone say totally toothless? Anyway, look, when it comes to our position, we need to be bold, frank, and stern. And Senator John Fetterman said, did someone say bald Frankenstein? Anyway, we can get this done, or we'll regret it and bicker. And Congressman Patrick McHenry said, some say Orville Redenbacher? Anyway, look, we really need to be in sync here. And finally, Senator Rand Paul said, did someone say in sync hair? That's just interesting. We just need to talk together. The whole thing. The whole thing. Wow. Wow. Some business news, Elon Musk said that the new Tesla Roadster will be able to go 0 to 60 in less than a second. I guess this is good. I'm not sure I need to break the sound barrier just going to Walgreens, but it's fun when you step out of the car, you just look like Biden's doctor, you know? Well, guys, everyone loves TikTok, but sometimes you just want to skip the boring parts of a video and get right to the good part. Am I right? For instance, if you're watching a video, you can skip this part. And you go right to this part.
Hello, sir.
There you go. See what I mean? See what I'm saying? Hello there. Here's another example. You can skip this part. Yeah, and go right to this part. Hoya! Next, you can skip this part. No, you have no idea. You think you have an idea, but you don't. You can skip that part and go right to this. What? Come on. What?
Come on, they're rented pants.
Oh, my God.
You can also skip this part.
Sorry, love. Mm-hmm.
And go right to this part. Sorry, Mom. And finally, you can skip this part.
Oh my God. Look, baby.
And go right to this. That stinks. Well, switching gears today, Netflix released new episodes of Love is Blind, and yeah, I love it. One of the most dramatic scenes was a big confrontation between Chelsea and Jimmy. Now, if you missed it, don't worry, because here to reenact that scene with actual lines from the show are the Roots' own Tariq and Questlove.
Thanks, Jimmy. Tonight, I'll be playing the role of Chelsea, a 30-year-old flight attendant from North Carolina who's confronting Jimmy for going out too much.
And I'll be playing Jimmy, a 27-year-old software salesman from North Carolina who's getting confronted by Chelsea for going out too much.
All right. Whenever you're ready.
Girls from the pod said, hey, your man's is out. Where are you? They saw you out. Mackenzie saw you.
Why are you hammering me on that?
Because, like, I don't want to be with someone who wants to go out and party.
Baby, I drove there, I had one drink, I came home.
But is that something I want to deal with?
I like to go out and have drinks socially.
Who are you with last night? Who are you with last night?
Oh, my God. I'm not going to sit here and talk to you about this.
Who were you with last night?
I was with 8 fraternity brothers and 2 of their girlfriends.
Well, I heard from other people that you were not with just fraternity brothers. I heard you were with Jess. Ooh.
I was not with Jess. I swear to God, I was not with Jess. I think you're insecure about the whole Jess thing.
Really?
You're bringing up Jess and Mackenzie, and I didn't see Mackenzie. And I damn sure didn't see Jess. I don't have a physical relationship with either of them.
You do, though. You effing do. You told me you effed her. I don't give a F, but I know you effed her, and you told me that.
Because I want you to trust me.
And I do. You're not single Jimmy anymore. You're not.
Oh, Questlove and Tariq, everyone, right there. Questlove and Tariq. That was acting at its finest. That's it. Thank you, Questlove, Tariq. Thank you very much. No, that's good. Thank you. That's it. We're thank you. We're good. Thank you very much. We're good. Thank you very much. And finally, a woman in California allegedly stole an idling Amazon delivery van because she was in a rush to get home. And now she's expected to arrive in prison in 1 to 2 business days. We have a great show. Give it up for the Roots, everybody. Hey guys, we had some sad news today. We just found out that Richard Lewis passed away. And he was a good friend of the show, a great guest. I think he was one of the greatest comedians to ever do it. Yeah. If you get a chance, go on YouTube and watch some of his stuff. He was unbelievable. I used to impersonate him all the time. He was a good friend, would send me things, but his HBO specials, his whole character and walking and I'm Doomed. Do you ever see the HBO special, I'm Doomed?
Yeah.
He'd be a hypochondriac. He'd be just so upset about everything. The special he did was great that he went to the hospital because he thought he had a heart attack or something. He didn't, you know. And he's like, this is terrible, doctor. He's complaining. And the nurse goes, I'm sorry, Mr. Lewis, someone's here to visit you. What? Your biggest fan. And he goes, hi, I don't really show. It's your biggest fan. And a contortionist walks in. It's so funny. Yeah, and you might know him also from Curb Your Enthusiasm. He was fantastic. I just think he's one of the greatest to ever do it. Our thoughts are with his family and friends. We're gonna miss you, Richard Lewis. Guys, we have a great show tonight. She's an Oscar, Emmy, Grammy, and Golden Globe winner who stars in the new HBO series, The Regime, which premieres this Sunday at 9 p.m. Kate Winslet is here tonight. She is a talented actor and director who stars in the new movie, Damsel, which starts streaming next Friday on Netflix. Robin Wright is here. And we got great music tonight from Maya Hawk. Stick around, we'll be right back with more Tonight Show, everybody. Come on back. Hey, hey.